So last night I got crazy and started cutting out a whole bunch of things, including something I wanted to show you guys, but I didn't video. But I've only done step one, so I'm going to stop and show you guys how to make bloomers. Bloomers are a really important thing for anybody who's playing dress up. I have often told the story of the gal who borrowed a hoop skirt dress, and your hoop skirts come all the way to the ground, right? So she didn't put on any sort of under things, and in the course of a dance, got to show absolutely everybody her purple and yellow polka dot panties because skirts swing and get smooshed, and when you smoosh a hoop this way, it goes that way and that way, and we all got to see them. So bloomers. Of course, you can just wear bicycle shorts, but what fun is that? I just happened to have a neighbor give me this piece of fabric that was exactly the right size to make a pair of bloomers. And this is why I was like, oh my God, these have to be bloomers. The lace at the bottom at the eyelet is just so fantastic. So a pair of bloomers is a single pattern piece. Let me show you what it looks like. So what we've got here is this is the waist, the top edge, the waistband. This and this are the butt seam and the front seam, and then these will be the side legs. So what'll happen is when you fold that in half, that will be along the leg, but we'll put this together. But at the moment, there are several patterns. You can find patterns like pajama pants are, imagine this is basically a fancy pair of pajama pants. Once in a while, among all of the rather complicated projects I like to do, let's just make a Henrician outfit or a ball gown. A ball gown generally takes a month, is my usual rule of thumb. Anything complicated. And that's not a month of sitting down and sewing nonstop. That's a month of sewing for a couple of hours in the evening or something. And the older I get, the more I have to be careful. I have like my neck and shoulders have issues, and so I only get a short budget for, and I just like so I accidentally got it right and cut it out with right sides together. I hadn't actually checked first, but I had to take a really careful look at the eyelet to figure that out. So now the first thing we're going to do is we're going to sew these curves. So that one, we're sewing the crotch basically, and that one, we're just going to sew both curves down. Because I don't need to do the fancy edging on it. I'm just serging this. It's not see-through. Nobody's going to see these edges. So if they're on a serger, it'll be fine. Hasn't worked with the serger before, it does give you this instant beautiful finished edge, but it is of course a fancy expensive piece of equipment, and you have to be careful. You can't make mistakes because watch this, it cuts as it sews. That's those shavings are what gets cut off as you sew along. When you're done, you want a long tail before you cut it off, and you cut it off in the middle. Yeah, right, I need to sharpen my scissors so that you have a tail for to tie off. So either just make a knot in the end, or you can take a needle and thread and work your edge into there, which is my preferred method of doing it. Here's that. The end, here's my tail. I thread this onto a needle, and then I just work the needle into the edge. Easy for me to say. There we go. So we just work the thread into the needle into the thread, pull it through, and then slice off the rest of that. But the edge of the tail from the serging is now buried into the edge of the seam. So now we pull that all apart, and I'm going to take the centers. We're going to make the center seam. So you put one end to the other end. And then once you pull that out, we're going to sew all along that edge. And we have we're going to have two legs. Da, da, da. We have the beginning of bloomers. The next thing we're going to have to do is fold over the top edge and make the casing for the waistband. Simple enough to do. I am really just going to get my seam ripper, seam thing. And I will probably make the casing, I'll probably get 3/4 inch elastic. So I've got 1 inch. And I happen to use the selvage edge when I cut this. So it normally you fold under 1/4 like that and then fold over the amount. I might have to do that anyway, just so that the pattern fits right. But then we're gonna sew that down on the regular sewing machine. So most of the time I get lazy and don't do this, but I'm actually going to iron down the fold here of the, for the casing. So I got this, as I said, at the 1 inch mark, and I'm just going to press this guy down. If you press it ahead of time, it goes so quickly and easily when you run it through the sewing machine.
When you're sewing down a casing, remember not to close it all the way. So I started in front of, I put the needle in front of the center seam so that after I go all the way around, you stop on this side of the center seam, and then you're going, you'll have a place to stick the elastic in and out.
So besides elastic, one can also put in a drawstring. Drawstrings would be far more period. These are my bloomers. They're only going to see like down by my knees. Hopefully they won't. If anybody is seeing my elastic waist under the corset, they're way too close. So I'm sticking it in where I'd said, and all you're doing is push and pull. So you push the safety pin through the casing that you just sewed down. Then you hang onto the safety pin and the fabric, and you tug from the other end and you pull the elastic in. So it's all you're gonna do is, I'm just going to push and pull and push and pull. Now that I'm on the far side, I'm going to put the safety pin through both layers of the elastic, very important step, and then we're gonna try them on. Now, an important thing to remember when trying on, well, you shouldn't have to, but if you try on a garment inside out, then the seams that you need to take in are accessible for you to fix. In this case, it's just a matter of yanking the elastic, but it is easier to do still if it's inside out. And da-da-da, I have bloomers!